G'day, it's Jamie, and welcome to Tandonella Tigers. Today, I'm reading an old newspaper article about thylacine or thylacoleo or even big cat sightings in far north Queensland in the early 1900s. So we'll get into it. This was published in the Johnston River Advocate and Innisfail News on Friday, the 31st of October, 1930, titled, As It Is Here, More Too. Writing in the Sydney Bulletin, Polycarp says, North Queensland has a mystery animal, the striped tiger cat or marsupial tiger. The scientists have accepted its existence, but are not sure that the creature is a marsupial. No museum as yet possesses a skin or skeleton, but the big cat with tiger-like stripes instead of spots is well known. Wilkins kept an eye out for a specimen during his trip around the Little Known Peninsula, but failed. The Aborigines and many old-timers know the animal well. The late Bill McCard brought the first one under public notice at Scrubby Creek near Herberton, but in those days, no one thought of preserving the remains. The big cat can kill a full-size kangaroo and has been known to pull down calves. The animal referred to is not the only strange creature seen in the far north. Some men have seen more varieties of snake than were ever at large, and later, and have also seen a new species of bat, known as the dingbat. Of course, it costs more to see these queer creatures than the price of admission to a zoo. The end. That's really interesting. This, so lots of people are seeing either big cats or thylacines or thylacoleos, as they're calling them, striped tiger cats or marsupial tigers. They say scientists have accepted its existence, which no, they haven't. And they're not sure whether it's a marsupial or not. They say it's well known for having tiger-like stripes instead of spots. The Aborigines all know about them, and many old-timers do too. Mr. Bill McCord shot one at Scrubby Creek near Herberton, and I remember I've read about this, and I'll find a newspaper article about this shortly. They brought it into the pub and had it on display at the pub at Herberton. And like in those days, no one thought of preserving the remains, but with the weather in North Queensland, it got pretty stinky pretty quick apparently, and they got rid of it. Okay, that's it for me. I'll get back to you all next time. Bye.